Okay, this is the usual then update, and we start with the planned releases. You know that we have a regular release plan with four major releases or one major release in May, and it will happen next week, 17th of May, and I will tell you some highlights of the highlights from that release. So here is what's new here. The shell, quite lot of things in the shell. Improvements of maps, improvements in the lists module, and you might know about the feature, and the feature concept. I will tell you about that. Changes. Improvements in the Erlang compiler and the JIT, and incremental mode for dialyzer. Arg parse is a new module, and then some SSL improvements. And you can read all about this in a blog post that we will publish next week together with the release. So now about the shell. One thing you notice with the shell is if you are a Windows user, we have removed the vRL executable. Now we are using a new Windows terminal feature that has been there for a while, but we have not used it until now. And with this, the shell in, or the terminal and the shell in Windows will be the same user experience as on Unix. More things in the shell. You can define functions directly in the shell. They are executed through this RL-eval, so they are not as efficient as compiled code, but you can copy-paste the function from a module into the shell and run it. And also, you can define records, types, and specs in the shell. Also useful if you want to copy-paste code from a module. The auto-completion is extended. You can auto-complete shell variables, record names and fields, map keys, and function parameter types, and also file names. If you start the parameter, the value with a double dash inside the function, it will complete to files in the current directory. Maps, improvement of maps. One is change ordering of atom keys for small maps, and another is introduction of map comprehensions as a language feature. The change ordering of atom keys is maybe not a big change, but as you can notice here, when you create the map in OTP 25, you get the order here, A, B, C. It's the sorted order of the atoms. But now in OTP 26, it might be C, A, B, or something else. It has never been guaranteed what the order is, so, but it is a difference now, so you can be surprised. This is an optimization. And because of that, we have added two new modifiers for the I/O formats. You can sort maps when you print them. You can even use a fun to sort them. Map comprehensions. With map comprehensions, you can create more beautiful or more smaller expressions for the same thing that you have used list comprehensions before. Like, you can use the map generator here. This expression with colon equals here, it's the key and the value. You take them one by one from the map, and then you can In this case, you can create another map with the value and keys interchanged. So there is also a map iterator new in OTP 26. In the lists module, there are new functions. Enumerate with three arguments where you can add first there's a start value, then it's the increment, that's new. Back again. So that's new. You have a family of enumerate then. Enumerate 1, 2, and 3. And zip, the zip family of functions. Now you can add an argument, an option for telling what to do if they have unequal length, the lists. Previously, there was a crash if they were unequal in length. So now you can trim. That means the shortest list is dominating, and you will only get the number of elements from the shortest list. And pad, then it will fill, take the longest list, and then we will fill the rest with the default value you provide. And you have one default value per list. This is the first list, and this is the second list. And if you have the zip3 function, you can have a third default. The maybe feature was introduced in OTP 25. And there was one switch inside the module to tell the compiler that you are activating the maybe feature. That you can see that here. This is an example of a module where you use the feature attribute to enable the maybe expert feature. And then when you start ALL and try to load this module, you will get an error because the runtime system refuses to load a module with the maybe feature because you have to enable the maybe feature in runtime as well. This runtime enabling thing has been removed, especially for a feature that is has only impact on the compilers. So you don't need this enable feature in runtime. Just do it in the module. Then we have a lot of improvements in the Erlang compiler and the JIT in OTP 26. Some of them are type-based optimizations, and others are matching and construction of binaries, which has made, for example, the Base64 module with encode and decode significantly faster. There are more features here that you can read about in a blog post already published since April somewhere. Dialyzer has got an incremental mode. It is implemented by Tom Davis from WhatsApp, and it can improve speed significantly when you have small changes in a few modules. So you use the incremental option, and then you have the warning apps, which tells that in this case you want to get warnings in the standard lib application only. And then you have the apps where you say which apps are included in the analysis. And if you then, for example, the first analyze here takes about 15 seconds. If you then, for example, just change something in one module in standard lib, and that module is not the lists module, because if it's the lists module, then it's used by all other modules. But if it's another, Base64, for example, used only by one or two or so, then it will take under a second to analyze next time. So it depends on the dependencies of the changes and how much the changes are. Here is another contribution from WhatsApp. The arg parse module has been added to the standard library. We can regard it as somewhat experimental now in the first release of OTP 26, but it's there for to stay. And with this, if you have a command line interface, for example, an e-script. I have one example here, like an e-head command with minus n option or minus lines or and a number of files, and you declare the command line with a map structure where you name the options and you can declare the type of the option and the default values. You have also short and long names, and then if you feed it like this, arg parse run, you get a map structure out of it with a fully parsed command line. And you will also get reaction if there is something error in the command line. So this is inspired, I think, by a similar feature for Python, but there are for many languages. There's another one for Erlang called getopt as well, used by Rebar. But if we should port Rebar, then I think we should use this one instead. And I think the new implementation also, introduction of this, as we have used argparse for the dialyzer CLI as a test. Dialyzer CLI is quite complicated, so it worked very well. SSL then. Safer defaults. If you, in OTP 25, you did this SSL connect, Erlang.org, the port number, and no options at all. That connection succeeded, but you get a warning report saying that you are not using the verify peer. So you are not verifying that the server is the server you think it is. In OTP 26, this verify peer is on by default. But then you also need to have a certificate or give the certificates. And you can do that by this option we have here. Then you get the standard options from the OS. You can provide other certificates if you want, but you must provide some certificates. Or another way is that you have to turn off the verify peer by saying verify none instead. Yes. That was all of the short story of the highlights. I can say something about what we are thinking about the next coming year. And no promises that we will do anything of this, but but probably something, yes. We will address how we write the documentation and tools for that. I mean, in OTP, we write the documentation with XML today. And it is not very fun writing it with XML. We intend to use Markdown instead, and we intend to do it, I mean, inspired by Elixir, how they do it, and maybe using the same EXDoc backend to produce the HTML. And maybe also write the documentation inside the modules. But it will be possible to write outside as well, I think. And Markdown is maybe not the absolutely best choice, but it is an obvious choice because it's so well spread. So I think it's the best choice for the moment. And it's well known, even if it's not well standardized. We will use a subset of, super subset perhaps, of Markdown. Because we have to handle, smart links between Erlang entities, like modules and things like that. Dialyzer, we will work more with Dialyzer also, and the type language, and other improvements, aiming for better type checking. We'll also investigate other tools for type checking, and we will try to cooperate with others, maybe WhatsApp, for example. We'll continue to improve the JIT and the compiler as well. Socket. There has been ongoing development with Socket for a long time, and now we are having a working or somewhat working version for Windows as well. And that has been stopping us before, and to have the complete Socket for all platforms. So we have Windows sockets in the OTP release, 26 release, but not fully. I mean, it's a beta status. So we intend to improve that during OTP 26. TLS improvements will also happen. And we will think about eventually some new language features. Maybe addressing the variable scoping. Maybe introduce a new integer range, BIF or a guard BIF, or even maybe language construct, I don't know. Depends. Now I'm saying too much. Something about project build model of Erlang. Memory profiling tools and memory footprint reductions. There are some customers that are sensitive to memory consumptions and some others that don't care about. Process labels is another thing that we have been thinking about. It's quite easy to add. It's about you can put the label on your process so that if you have, some customers have hundreds of thousands of processes and you want to know, you want to find all processes of a certain category, and that's not really visible with, if you start them with as Yen servers, all of them, for example, they all have the same initial function and they are not easily distinguishable from each other. And then maybe something about private export of functions and types. So you want to export a function or a type inside one application, but not to the world. They are internal. Or maybe making the applications known entity for the compiler, I don't know. JSON is also on the table. I mean, maybe it was a mistake 10 years ago that not taking in JSON as in the standard libraries. At that time, or I think Ericsson was not interested at all in JSON, but now everyone have to use JSON because of this cloud native. They have to have this efficient serialization format. So, just a bit about statistics. I have used this before. This is statistics about pull requests to the OTP repo. And I think the trend is very good. It's increasing. I mean, the last values here, they are from the May the 10th. So if we interpolate here, we can think that this will be higher than the highest before. So this is less than half a year. And thank you very much for your contributions. You can continue with them. Yes, that's all.